frontier. I tried to picture clusters of information as they moved through the computer. What did they look like? Ships, motorcycles. Were the circuits like freeways? I kept dreaming of a world I thought I'd never see. And then, one day, I got in.
So, this is the fancy little thing that I use when it's just me to start with. Dougie, hi. Michael, hi. As you can tell, it's just me for right now. Will is at EGX. Chris is at a wedding. And here I am, stuck in the middle with you. So, I know Will had some plans for some thing do's. And I'm pretty sure we're going to see if we can't help him out with that. So my question to you guys, the chat, is do we want to have just a chill morning where we all just kind of hang out and talk? Do you want me to pull up some video games? Or you play some games while we actually talk? Do I want to pull Dougie into the chat and do the show with him? What do you guys feel like? It's up to you. I'm totally... got games prepared if we want to play games. I got podcasting prepared if we want to podcast. I got chill beat hip hop if we just want to hit chill here and listen to some like cool anime beats hip hop. Your thoughts? I'm gonna have my one man show as I talk about the various things that is going on right now in the gaming world. That too. So, tell me, chat. What do you think? What do you want to hear? What do you want? How can I entertain you this morning? It's easy going.
All right.
It's all about keeping... Let's take a look here. I should probably pull up some news or something, huh? Well, it is EGX. It's also PDXCon this weekend as well, which is, of course, as you know, Paradox Interactive. So I guess we'll go into content dump, right? Let's talk. Everybody, let's talk about some content. Let me create content for you. Since that's why you're here, for me creating content for you. Let's look at some news stories. Let's look at some interesting stuff. Let's wait for ads to stop playing so I can actually do what I'm doing. Actually, nah, I'm not going to put that on. I could put the lo-fi hip-hop beats in the background, but we don't know if we'll demonetize the channel or not. So what's happened since we last talked, everybody? Let's think about this. What happened? More content dump. I love this good content. It's nothing like a good content dump first thing in the morning. Let's get on with the rest of your day feeling refreshed. But let's see here. Well, I think since we last talked, Doom Eternal got pushed back. Right? So, till 2020. Which, in my mind, isn't a bad decision. And I'm pretty sure Chris and Will mirror me on that. That It's not a. It's you never have a game can never be bad if you put more time into it. But a rush game that's put out to completion before it's ready is never good. Will's still in the queue to play it. Well, he'll be able to tell. He may be in the queue for the next couple of months to play it. It's good for the game. Bethesda is smart to push something back if they know it's not going to be good or they don't feel it's up to snuff. But I think you're getting more modes because of it as well, which is a boon. You know, hey, we're pushing it back, but we're going to give you more stuff, which is always, always good. So that's not that's good, right? We can all agree that, hey. Oh, sorry, I'm looking at Anthem apparently is releasing Mass Effect armor, but that also means that people have to play Anthem, and that's just not fun. Let's switch over to this website to see what other news is there are. Some interesting news stuff here. But to end the point here on our good old friend Bethesda and Doom, they've had a lot of missteps with games that they've rushed. Obviously, Bethesda is only the publisher for Doom. Id Studios does Doom. Correct me if I'm wrong there. But the fact that it's a... Yeah, I'm playing Doom 3 in anticipation. Doom 3 is less than $3 on the PSX. Yeah, there's some good deals. Doom 3, there's also just Doom. Was it Doom 2016? The prequel to Doom Eternal? They're all great games, and it's a good one. It's a good place to start, for sure. And you can always just play the classic Dooms as well. Just Doom 1, Doom 0. Wolfenstein. You can play Wolfenstein, which is essentially that. And maybe if you feel up to it and it gets on discounted enough, Rage 2 is kind of like an open world Doom. Feels that way. A lot of, with especially the way the movement and the all those mechanics work. Let's see what else is going on here. Paradox talked about is having their major con this weekend as well, PDX con, and it's very, very interesting. Finally said that they're going to release Crusader Kings 3. For those of you who don't know the Crusader Kings series, it's basically what if you went through the entire Middle Ages in Europe. It's a great series, and the fact that they're actually bringing it and not just doing more DLC is awesome. Though we did also get DLC plans for Planetfall, for I'm sure it's not EU4, but BattleTech, and a bunch of other games that I'm just forgetting. I added them all. James, you added them all to your Steam library, didn't you? Yes, you did. Let's look a look at them. Let's pull up the Steam library and actually see what's going on here. Publisher sale. They announced Imperator Rome, Punic Wars, Planetfall, Revelation, Hearts of Iron 4, La Resistance, Stellaris Federation, Crusader Kings 3, you've got Vampire the Masquerade Bloodlines 2, you've got the Psych Ward edition of Prison Architect, and you've got Empire of Sin, which is a kind of mafioso turn-based strategy game based in, like, Chicago in the 1920s. Which, you know, any game based in Chicago in the 1920s with Tommy guns can always be a good laugh and a good time. So, Paradox, obviously a bunch of Paradox games are extremely discounted. You can get Stellaris incredibly cheap, Shadowrun incredibly cheap, City Skyline, they have a new Stellaris pack out, or it's going to be out. Excuse me, coffee hasn't hit yet. It's gonna have be able to play stone people. Oh, it looks really just exactly like what you would expect. They also have these talked about Survive Aftermath, which is a game where you are playing in a post-apocalyptic world, Earth, and you're trying to survive. It's kind of a successor to Surviving Mars, only because it's like in the surviving series of games. But it looks good. Everything. I mean, I'm a Paradox fan, so I'm sitting on my podium right here, and nobody can tell me otherwise. So, I'm all for it. Just moving on through us. Apparently, and I'm just reading. Ooh. I'm just reading through just various websites right here. Twitch is now going to test long requested watch parties, which means it will streamers can stream Amazon Prime movies and shows with their followers, along with they have a subscription, which Twitch allows. Twitch is owned by Amazon. It started sending out invitations for streamers to test it out. So it looks like we can start doing things where we can start watching movies and stuff together, which is absolutely amazing. You can sit here and sit down and watch TVs, watch movies. I mean, they kind of did this in the past. You had those streamers where Amazon would ask to do streamers would be like, hey, stream the first episode of Jack Ryan, stream this, and it's very good. I mean, Twitch has got to evolve. It's never going to be just a video game streaming site. So this seems like a great thing, kind of going forward. I mean, how many years it was we kids where we sitting down and we watch. I remember, God, the second season of Pokemon when it came out in the United States. We had a watch party. All of us got together on Saturday morning, hung out at a kid's house, and watched the first episode of Pokemon. There's about 12 of us singing that theme, the Pokemon theme, as the show came on. I forget what happened. I can't tell you what happened in the episode, or how, or what, and much else from the day. But I just remember that all of us singing that song. But I think over the past year or so, good friends. Yeah. Oh, great! So you have so Dougie's got the beta for points and tokens. That's awesome. How is that, by the way? Have you seen what have your thoughts been on the bits tokens kind of thing? Points tokens in chat. Because I can see where they're going with all of this. It seems like they're trying to move away from bits and tokens and everything being involved in your OBS, and they're trying to bring it more to their side so everything flows through them more. It's just interesting how you can see how they're trying to make things more interesting, make things more run more through Twitch, which I'm all for. Hell, I am gonna be extremely happy to do watching thing, watch shows with everybody. I don't know what I would watch, but I'm sure we could find something. It's just a nice another thing. I mean, especially with Extra Life too, between playing games and then maybe sitting down and watching something. Because I know there are guys who do streams where donations and media clips come on, and people can donate money to play a media clip, and how many seconds or minutes is a great thing. That's never thought of that. Yeah, you're right. It's a good way to review is to reward people who don't have sub badge, who can't afford sub badges and emotes, and that's and yeah, and I get that. I mean, not everybody has the ability to, top down what? One of these, or one of these. And I get that. I don't even who's got who are we? I forget who we're sub to. I think I don't know who we're sub to. Apparently, I have an Overwatch one too. Don't know where I got it from, where it's going, but. Yeah, no, it makes sense that that's what you do. Yeah, make like an emote for 24 hours. Oh, yeah. So you watch, you unlock, you click the little chest thing, you get the points, and then you use those points to unlock an emote, and it lets you kind of do that. It's also kind of like a nice kind of pre-sale kind of thing too, because it lets you kind of like people can kind of explore the emotes and stuff at their leisure and see if they like them, and then kind of go from there. See if they want to continue with it or if they... Hello? Will! Good! How is it from the Game Floor VGX? We can tell. Everybody, Will from the Game Won't Play Itself podcast, live reporting from the floor. There we go.
I haven't played games this morning.
I just had to turn your mic on, Will. Now we can hear you. So, Will, the question is from chat right now is, are you still in the Doom queue? Will, can you hear me? Bark twice if you're in Milwaukee.
It's like Aaron and I. Yeah, we just moved down. Played Doom this morning. Doom is really, really good.
Okay. Can confirm
like
Doom is good. Good, good. What else is going on?
Well, I have actually tried that new Contra game.
Okay.
I have to be with Jim Sterling, I think. Yeah. Let's play them some Concrete Genie, which I have no idea what the game's about, what the game's doing, so. Yeah, we're just going to stand in line for Borderlands 3.
Mm-hmm. So obviously Will's breaking up a little bit because of the craziness there. Will. And he's gone. So that was Will from Doom is good. A lot of teammates Terry especially will be the case. Yep. Doom is really good. That's the quote of the podcast. So if anybody had any questions about Doom, I think we'll just solve them for us all there. Doom is good. That's all I think I needed to hear. Everybody go out and buy Doom now, because it's going to be amazing. Can you even buy Doom Eternal? Questions on a postcard. Doom Eternal. Yes. Looks like you can pre-order it. Yep. Yeah, you can pre-order it. Also, regular Doom is $20 right now on PC. So, but yep, Doom Eternal you can pre-order. It does have a deluxe edition. So if you pre-order Doom Eternal Rip and Tear Pack, a copy of Doom 64, the Doot Revenant's player skin, throwback shotgun, and a bonus campaign master level. And the deluxe one gives you the Demon Slayer skin, classic weapon sound pack, year one pass for includes DLC 1 and 2, and the Doom Eternal game guide? It's also on Keymailer. It's true. It is also on Keymailer. The likelihood of us getting anything off of Keymailer, though, is slim to none. Doesn't mean you can't ask, though, right? I mean, usually if you say pretty please, sometimes people say yes. Where is Keymailer on here? Yeah, it's going to be very, very expensive. Then, I mean, it would have been. Well, let's look at, like, I think we've talked about this. Like, that section of year is going to be absolutely insane. Between, I mean, you've got Cyberpunk coming out that time, you've got Doom coming out that time. Those are just going to be two very, well, long games. Excuse me. God, I'm really tired this morning. Normally, I'd have other people talking, trying to keep me awake. Spaceland? What's Spaceland? Oh, really? Oh, that's cool. That's kind of a game I was looking into. Let's look at it. Yeah, there's no reason not to ask for keys. What's new? Yeah, there's a lot of I got a lot of keys I requested. Hey, but that's why you stream, right? You stream to have fun with people, to interact with your viewers. But also, maybe companies will be nice to you and give you stuff. Because you never know. Okay, let's do this while we're doing it. Let's see if I can get this to work. Always important questions. Because I've been messing with our stream settings lately, guys. I don't know if you can tell. But I've been trying to tweak it a little bit, give you a sharper image, give you less motion blur and stuff when we do this kind of stuff. Just to kind of see how it would go and what would happen if we did this kind of stuff. What if I do this? Oh, ooh, okay. All right. Let's try something here. Don't worry. Just because my pretty face is going away doesn't mean I'm leaving you. Far from it. But is this? Nope. Do I have my webcam here? Let's see here. Do 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 do. Add source. There it is. Look, here I am. Let's just shrink me down and put me down here in the corner. For right now, at least. We'll move. I should be right around here. All right. Let's see if this works. Cross your fingers. And where is it? There it is. Boop. Done. Aha! Nailed it. Because we're having one of those kind of days. Why don't we all just chillax for a little bit? Because content dump's kind of dumb. Dumb. Yeah, right. Done. Content dump is done. So, actually, now that I'm thinking about it, right? Because I'm here and I'm looking this way. So, shouldn't I move my webcam, boop, over here? That way, when I'm like looking, it looks like I'm looking into the screen. Oh, but we're not going to miss too much important data. So, this is the football. Let's just go here. We'll go right here. This is the beloved Football Manager save that I've been playing since the game came. Now, let's take a look here. This is Tigwhippies FC. Let's look at the club. So this is the club that I believe I started in tier. Oh, how far back was it? I'm gonna get Football Manager 2019. Obviously, soccer. casual playthrough. There we go. So, this is the team. This is TickWhippies FC. It was founded in the year 2017. Obviously, we're in October 25th of 2030. Since the inception of the team, I should just go to my career. History, competitions. We've won the Champions League 3 years. We've won the Premier League 5 years. We've won the World Cup Championship 3 years. We won the Europa League, Europa Super Cup twice, runner-up once. We've won the FA Cup 4 times. We've won the Skybet Championship once. We've won the Caballero Cup 5 times. League One, English Community Shield. You know, we've been pretty prolific as a team. Let me go to my profile. So, here I am, my profile. Let's take a look at my career. Obviously, all those career escalate milestones all right here. My career stats. Here we go. Since I've been here, one club. I've been at the club for almost 4,500 days. I bought 218 players. At 1.1 billion. I've sold players at 1.3 billion, which means I've made a profit. Go me, turning a profit. Kept $90 million in fees paid to agents. Highest fee I've ever received was 97 million pounds for this guy, who is now at Bayern Munich and doing all right for himself, but he was my backup striker and complaining about not playing. I've accompanied $13 million in my career. Where is my win percentage? It's a lot of trade. Yeah, it's been good here. It's been very good here. Yeah, the entire career at TickWhippies FC. Landmarks, awards, competitions, transfers. Yeah, James Ackes is his first non-playing role as TickWhippies head coach. During the time of the streamers, Atkins' team lifted the Premier League Trophy, Championship, Skybet League One, Skybet League Two, Vanarama National, English Trophy, Club World Cup. Yep. So, I've been pretty good. Let's see games played. So, I've won 666 games. Doom Eternal. I've drawn 54 games and lost 35 games in my entire career with this team. We don't lose a lot. Let's talk about the squad. Is this my best team? Yes. Quick pick. So this is the best team I have right now. This guy. Daniel Seti. God, I got him way back when. 2013, I bought him for 10 million pounds from Bayern. And he has just been prolific. Like this year, he scored 44 goals in all competitions. 49 goals in all competitions. 40 goals in all competitions. 11 goals. Or 35 goals in all competitions. How many hours do I have in the save? All of them. All of my hours have been in the save. I've only played this. This has been the only save I've played. I'm really excited about, where's our kid? So we got this kid. Our English striker, younger wonder kid. Capped internationally at 19. 2 caps, 1 goal. I think he's a local boy. Haven't. England. He's declared for us. But we have a killer squad. Booth was another one of our guys who we originally had him for years. He left. And then he left Arsenal and we got him on a free back. And he's just been great for us down the right wing. Lambert has been here forever as well. Got him on a free. And he's just been our attacking midfield god. Hamilton, this guy, Australian. We picked him up from Fulham, sent him to Tottenham because he wanted to go. They sent him on loan. We got him 7 million back from Tottenham, and he's just been great. But I think this is the guy. Our back line has been anchored by Eviardo. We got him in League Two from Brazil, and he has just been our best defender. And Los, once again, got him that same year, and it just kept the back line steady. Peraza, our Mexican goalkeeper, got him from America. You can see once we hit SkyBet League 2 and became a fully pro club, we got a lot of good players. Let's continue on here. Let's get to... Oh, we're going to be playing Everton today. Let's play the game. I think that sounds good. We'll play some FM. Play a game or two. Match or two. But this has been the save that I've played. And obviously we all know that I think November 19th, Football Manager 2020 comes out. And that's when everything changes. Got some homegrown players, fitness tests. That's fine. All right, Everton. So, what does our fitness look like? Everybody's relatively fit. Let's play with the best 11. Santa Maria on the bench. Victoria, Tommy Bowler's coming back from injury. I don't really want to risk him, but I'll keep him on the bench. Defender, Lopez, Callum Dorn. I don't have any... Oh, I do have midfielder. I wonder if anybody who can play... Where's Woodley? I'll take Woodley over Bowler. Just that we have somebody who can play. Yeah. All right, here we go. We'll be able to see these guys in action against a decent team. I think Everton's like middle of the table here. Booth, Lambert, Nierdo. Great Spanish winger. Just, once again, we're at the point now where we just buy whatever top talent we want. Beshkov, who is just a killer Austrian midfielder. He's our advanced playmaker. He gets forward, where Hamilton is more of a deep line playmaker, plays more defensively, works the ball out from the defense. Our wingbacks are great. Definitely more attacking, but they've got some good, decent defense. But I trust our center backs completely. Pep talk. Best go out there and have fun. I have faith. Basically, if every single time I tell these guys I have faith in them, they're just lit. They love it. The tunnel, send the assistant. I never do these tunnel talks. All right. Let's see us versus Everton. Now, we do play a 4-2-3-1. And we always play it, and we're very attacking. Now, they're playing a 4-4-1-1. So we'll see how this goes. I'm expecting good things. That being said, not a lot going on in the first couple minutes of the match. Still, normally we have an attack by now. I'm not going to say I'm worried, but I mean, 70% percentage of the ball, one shot on target. These guys must be playing defensively. Hamilton booked. I'm not worried about that. Let's shout. Show some passion. There we go. They're all fired up by the feedback. 30 minutes into the game and still nothing's happened. I go tell you, hey, we're this powerhouse European team. We've won the Champions League. We've won this. We've won that. And just nothing. What are these guys doing? Waiting for the next highlight. There's not going to be a highlight in the first half, is there? It's going to be like the ball kicked out to like end the half. That's all we're going to get. Oh, here you go. Everton free kick. Oh, if they score at the death here. Okay. What happens here? Briscoff controls. Brings it to bad pass, but Damba. Booth heads it down to Damba. Eviardo. Dimba. Eviardo. Speculative ball to Seti. Doesn't fall. Basuta gets it to Lambert. Gets Nierdo. Who cuts in. Seti! It's like, what, the second shot we've had? Oh, the sixth shot we've had on goal all game. I don't know what I can tell you guys. It's... They're a good team, I swear. They're a very good team. Okay. So that was a boring half. Pep talk here. We're going to just get aggressive. It says, I'm far from pleased what I just saw. I've won a couple league titles. Yeah, well, the thing is, like, I won't say I made it hard on myself. Tig Whippies FC started in the lowest league. We were a professional team. We did have a $500,000 startup, and we got like $5,000 in revenue every year from our Twitch streaming money. But that's where we went. I'm gonna aggressively tell him, I'm not happy. I'm not happy. I'm not happy. Fire them all up. It's a good way to motivate these players. Just get in there and yell at them. What are you doing? All right, let's see where we can go here. Perza plays out the back to Los. Suda on the ball. Nerdo. Okay, we're going to drive this up. Yeah, we are. Past one. Past two. Is he going to take it on himself? Oh, wow. Gets his own rebound. That was a hell of a run from him. Oh, my God. There he is again. Goal! Takes it up the flank and just... Beautiful. I don't know why we're seeing like the replay on the miss, but we know it's a goal. All right. So we know that's a little bit... Kevin Barnett, is he a real player? No, he's not a real player. Great run. Yeah, great run and a great goal. So I think at the 60th minute, we're going to make a change here. Yeah, 60 minute, we'll make a change. Just about there. All right, 60-minute tactics. Booth has been kind of tired, so we're going to take him off. We're going to bring in Roberto Lopez, push Lambert out to that right wing, and I'm going to take Seti off because he's not having a good game. And we'll put Dorian, who is a interesting brown-headed, blonde-bearded wonder kid. And see if we can't get him going. And we'll press that and we'll play. Let's see where we go from there. So, changes have been made. Back out in the game. Back out in the field. Let's just see if we can see out this half. Oh, Lambert with a free kick. Dangerous area. Nerdo again. Lopez. Nothing. Nerdo's been really the one directed out of that left-hand side. Free kick for them. Lopez wins it. Dorian brings it up. Slides through to Lambert. Lambert to Briscoff. He loves... Okay, we'll play it back. Hamilton. Suita. Cross. Not so much. Let's see where it can go here. Kick it into the shins, guys. Uh-oh, that's not good. But the pass isn't going to go anywhere. Highlight's still going here, so we still got the build-up play. Lambert, wow. That was a pass. Was he offside, though? Nerdo with just the beautiful run. I think 15 keeps him onside. Yep, no flag goes up. Don't double check the thing. He's definitely having a game. All right. We've got room for one more sub. Lambert looks tired, but we can keep him there. Let's get Suta off for Woodley. Woodley's a great wing back. And they've made their final subs based off an injury. Yeah, he gets booked in the 72nd minute. Shrong Chardong? Shradong? Injured in the 76th. Now it's just a matter of seeing out the game. So Nerdo with two wonderful goals. Oh, Lambert, free kick, dangerous spot. He's definitely out of place now. So Lambert with a goal and an assist. Nerdo with two goals. Wow. That doesn't get much better than that. Beautiful free kick by Lambert. Lambert's tried to leave a couple times. The PSG and Real Madrid have come a knocking, but we've been able to keep a hold of him. This is probably just a highlight to end the game. Beautiful free kick. Gotta imagine Garcia lumps it down the field. Ref, that's full time. Great win. I'll do a pep talk here. Well done, guys. That was a great win for us. I'm happy with that. Got the Caballero Cup fourth round against Burnley coming up. We can play a rotated squad. Caballero Cup's not big for for us here. Tigwhippies FC hammer Everton. Tigwhippies FC had their midfield to thank for the afternoon at the King Power Stadium. By the way, our stadium is being upgraded, so we're playing at the King Power Stadium with Leicester this year. While we're getting a 40,000 seat stadium. Two goals from Daniel Nerdo. Tigres succeeded to victory. Outstanding winger Nerdo gave Tigres with a short placed range in the 47th minute, added his second goal of the game with a placed shot from close range in the 70th. Everton's Shaarting was forced off with a twisted ankle, following a tackle by Robert Lopez. A standing attacking midfielder, Robin Lambert, completed the route with a free kick from the top corner in the 88th minute. Tigres are currently on an 11-match unbeaten streak. In the league, stretching back to last day, and the title contenders lie in first place in the Premier League and have won their last five home games. Nerdo was great. He's superb in front of goal. Obviously, our nickname is the Streamers for various reasons. Yeah, we'll go back to if we want to look at Everton. Yeah, they had Diego Jota. Where was he? Jota. Jota. Suspended from, yeah, he's 33, Diego Jota. Now, he's had a let's see what his career's been like. Yeah, Wolves and then £57 million move to Everton, where he's been pretty solid. Two years with 13 goals. It's pretty good. He's had a pretty good career. Yeah, at this point, there's not too many real life players left in the game. I mean, I like a lot of the young wonder. I think João Felix is still around. João, yep, João Felix. He is an attack with Man City. He's 30. but it's career stats. Yep, so he went to Man City. Obviously, this is before everything else. He went to Man City for £54 million and just stayed there. Did all right for himself. But Man City has been kind of second fiddle to us in a lot of ways. They got a lot of good players now, Man City. Not as good as us, obviously. Oh, Andexen or Gudvin is there. 34-year-old Russian midfielder. João Felix. Rodrigo. So there's just still a few with Edin Militao. Still there. So yeah, there's still plenty anger of the poor for Dambler told that Atkinson lost his temper with the team and 3-0 victory. The outstanding folder, they actually had not been happy with the team and made sure that they knew it. Of course it did. It's how it works. They suck. I yell at them. I yell at them to get better, and they get better. And that's how we do it here at Tigrupis FC. All right. So I'm going to save this game here. We've been going for about an hour or so. Quick little quiet podcast. And this is still playing. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Keeper. I mean, well, keep think about it. Keepers have a hell of a life in this game. I mean, Buffal is still playing nowadays, and he's still a top-rated keeper. Wouldn't say as much a world class as he has been, but still top-rated. Let's go back to chatting here. See? So that's it. That's, I think, the show. I think it's a good show for the weekend, right? There'll probably be more streams throughout the weekend. I have been playing a lot of Destiny, and there's been a lot of Destiny streams going up. So check that out if you want to see Destiny content. I'm trying to ramp up the streams a little bit as we get closer to Extra Life. For Extra Life, I'm thinking of playing Outer Worlds. That's probably going to be the game we're going to go with, unless something else changes between now and then. But look at that. Probably be our first playthrough of Extra Life, of the Outer Worlds. But yeah, nice, chill, relaxed stream to start your morning and go along with the middle of your afternoon. And hope you all had fun. We'll talk to you all later. We'll be back from EGX next week. It will be the last stream we have before Extra Life. And then Extra Life happens that weekend, next weekend, weekend after. You know what I mean. So everybody, have a great evening, great morning, great time. We'll catch you all later. Have fun.